TFNN. Headline news update.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN, 9 a.m. Eastern Time, Friday morning, 30 minutes to go until that opening bell. And we got markets in negative territory, but off the lows of the session pre-market. Right now, you're looking at S&P negative by about 8 points, trading at 3218. NASDAQ futures negative 84, 10,463. The Dow negative by 61 points, trading at 26,482. Overnight, you had Asia. How about the Shanghai? Down almost 3.9% in the Shanghai. The Nikkei down about 0.6%. In Europe, you're looking at the DAX down about 1.6% right now. The FTSE off 1.2. CAC roll down about 1.2 as well. We'll start things off with the S&P. Highs yesterday, pre-market, 3284. The cascade to negative prices really begins at about noon Eastern time from 3270. We finish the day out at give or take between about 3220 and 3230, actually dipped below 3200 in the futures briefly by less than a point to 3199.25. We catch a little bit of a bid, currently trading 3216. Jumping around to commodities, gold, how about it? Did charges higher. We're within about $2, the highs we had yesterday, 1897.70. Talk about an upward trend. Look at that channel from basically last week, right? We opened the week Sunday night. Futures were trading at about 1810. We might close out the week above 1900 for some context on gold. How about that nice solid cup formation? The all-time high is 1923.70. We're within about $25 of that price level at 1895. Putting back on the shorter time frame, crude contract up about 25 cents at 41.32 this morning. And jumping around, how about that VIX spiking as the market trailed off to negative prices? We go from 23.60 up to 28.35 at the end of the day yesterday. That was correlating to when you had the markets, S&P dipping below 3200, still above 27 at 27.09. All right, jumping around to some of the stories out there. The first one, China retaliating for our closure of the consulate in terms of the Houston consulate. Yes, the China closed its consulate in Houston. So now China's saying we have to close our consulate in Chengdu. Things escalating, folks. We got a lot of closures that they could come, whether it's embassies, consulates. You see the areas, our embassy in Beijing, a lot of consulate offices, the first step in ratcheting it up. And I got to jump over to Intel shares this morning. They're going to struggle with their next generation chips, and they're paying the price, folks, down about $8 from 60.40. You're talking about 13% to the downside on earnings. Should be an interesting Friday in the markets. Stay tuned, folks. Larry Pesavento coming up live with Jim C. right now. Right back.